coral's really interesting. It's a fascinating thing because it's an animal and it's considered an ecosystem engineer. So it actually builds structure. Similar to trees, you know, provide habitat for other animals, coral reefs do the same thing.
The Florida Reef Tract is really a national treasure. It's the only nearshore coral reef in the continental United States. It's one of the most biologically diverse places on the planet.
It's estimated that over 70,000 jobs exist in Florida because of the Florida Reef Tract, and it helps to bring over 16 million visitors to the state of Florida.
The number of species that are on coral reefs rival anywhere on Earth. There's more species than a rainforest. Millions and millions of people survive off of coral reefs.
The Florida Reef Tract has declined by over 80% since the 1970s. We've had massive dredging projects that we estimate killed at least 500,000 corals, more likely double that, and affected the reef for several kilometers around Miami. We're in an urgent crisis on the Florida Reef Tract now, and we need all the resources possible to really protect, save, and restore the reefs.
This mission is unique. It's bringing together colleagues from the Scripps Institution of Oceanography, Mote Marine Labs, and then also the team from Woods Hole is going to be doing microbiologies. Even though we have a diverse set of scientific interests, we're all working together collaboratively, planning out each day to figure out what sites we're going to go to and how we're going to meet the goals of the expedition. We're going to be covering upwards of 250 miles of the Florida Reef Tract, and our goal is to survey 100 sites in 2 weeks. So as you guys know, we're at the most remote place of our trip in the Dry Tortugas. Yesterday we were kind of working, as Aaron said, to the west, but now we'll be working up to the north. Just, it's pretty treacherous. Like, if you look at the nautical chart, this actually gives a good representation of what's in there. And so even with some of the small boats, you know, we have to navigate through these coral heads.
Not very often do people have access to the entire Florida Reef Tract within 2 weeks, but this mission allows us to do just that.
Scripps is responsible on this mission for conducting large area imagery surveys. We've been working with colleagues at the University of California, San Diego to develop this technology with partners across the world, actually, to use a series of 5,000 images to create a large model, a view of an entire reef. What's happening on a reef is really dynamic. You know, you have multiple species of corals, algae, you have fishes, and so we're able to map out every single individual coral colony in that space. And so we can go back year after year and actually track how those corals change through time.
Over the last 5 years, we've been dealing with a new devastating coral disease outbreak throughout Florida called the stony coral tissue loss disease. It's been causing widespread mortality throughout the entire reef tract, with some mortality rates of up to 100% of the species once it hits a reef. The pathogen hasn't been identified yet. There's still a lot of research that we need to do in order to identify that pathogen. We can't just walk away from coral reefs. They're too important to our ecosystem in the world, and they're too important to our economy and our society. The more research we can do and the more steps forward we can make, the closer we are to making sure that this ecosystem survives long term.
I definitely tend to be more optimistic about things. You know, it's not what you see always in the news today with gloom and doom. And yes, there are certain places that are doing poorly, but there's other sites, they're doing quite well. And so we're trying to learn what are the things that people are doing to promote reef health versus the degradation that we're seeing other places.